while I'll be outside. You feel me?
Tragedy turned triumph. It's David and Goliath. I made it to the eye of the storm, feeling torn like they fed me to the lions. Before my time start to wind down like the Mayans, I show them how I got to grind down like a science. It sounds like a riot on hush. It's so quiet, the only thing I hear is my heart. I'm inspired by the challenge that I find myself standing eye to eye with. To move like a wise warrior and not a coward. You can't escape the history that you was meant to make. That's why the highest victory is what I'm meant to take. You came to celebrate, I came to celebrate. I hate losing, I refuse to make the same mistakes.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Thank you. I am Captain Carlos Enriques of the Newark Fire Department, the Department of Public Safety's Fire Division. I would like to welcome you today to the official graduation ceremony of the 51st Newark Fire Division recruit class. Today, the city of Newark is making fire department history. To the largest fire recruit class ever to graduate in the city of Newark. I would be remiss if I did not mention that today we are in this brand new facility, a magnificent facility, the state-of-the-art training facility for both the fire and police divisions. And it is only fitting that the largest recruit class in Newark fire history has the opportunity to have their graduation ceremony within this building. Please be sure to turn off your cell phones or switch them to silent mode. Please keep the aisles clear for the duration of the graduation ceremony. Thank you. I would ask that all uniformed personnel in attendance with us today remain covered during our ceremony. Please follow the instructions uncovered and recovered during the program. The 51st Newark Fire Division recruit class will now be ushered forward by Battalion Chief Stephen LaPenta, Captain Ramadan Edwards, Captain Gerald Wyopen, Firefighter Donald Alexander, Firefighter Camilla Barnes, Firefighter Gilberto Gonzalez, Firefighter Andre Roberts, and Firefighter Jose Marrero. Everyone, please rise for the presentation of the colors by the Newark Fire Division Honor Guard and the Newark Fire Department Pipes and Drums Band.
Detail, firefighters, present, four.
Police Officer Rashonda Merritt of the Newark Police Division will now sing the national anthem.
What so proudly we've hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we've watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home?
Thank you, Officer Merritt, for that beautiful rendition of our national anthem. Everyone, please remain standing for a moment of silence and reflection for the brave men and women who lost their lives protecting our nation, both at home and abroad, as well as for our dear brothers and sisters of the Newark Fire Division that we have lost along the way. At this time, I ask that everyone please remain standing for the welcoming prayer presented by our council member at large, Reverend Louise Scott Roundtree.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
They asked me to do the welcoming prayer, and they said that they wanted it turned up because this was the first and the largest. So I think we can really make some noise as we go before the throne of grace. Can we put our hands together and just clap and celebrate what the first is and what the largest is here in the city of Newark in this brand new facility? Let us pray. Dear God of all creation, because you are the source of all that is good, and the source of all of our blessings, because of all that you are, we want to thank you for blessing us with the gift of today. As we invoke your presence in this place, we want to thank you for family, friends, officials, and community, and guests who have come to see their loved ones elevated and begin a new chapter. Dear God, we now ask you to be with our graduates and their families in a very special way as they face the challenges of a firefighter's day. I pray that you continue to help them to be the best that they can be, for there are many people who will be depending on them like me. And when the duty calls to danger, walk closely by their side, to instill in them great courage and be their guide. Now we pray as we invoke your presence in this beautiful facility. We pray that you continue to be their strength, continue to be their comfort, continue to be their guide. And while you're doing that, God, while we're praying for their strength, while they're praying for their courage, while we're praying for their families, we pray for our mayor and the entire North Department of Public Safety and the officials. We pray, God, as I stand here coming before your throne of grace, that you will cover us, that you will keep us, that you will bless us. And every step that they take and every move that they make, God, you will be with them every step of the way. We thank you, oh God, for this opportunity. We thank you, oh God, for keeping them. We thank you, oh God, for leading them. Now we pray this prayer in the name of some who call you Jesus. Some call you Allah. Some call you Yahweh. Some call you Elohim. But we thank God that we have a God and a creator. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Y'all can clap.
Thank you, most gracious council member, Reverend Scott Roundtree. Please be seated.
Pizza! Bread! Seats!
Before we begin, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge all of the dignitaries and VIPs who are present and in attendance with us today, as well as all other invited guests. First, the Honorable Raj J. Baraka, Mayor of the City of Newark. Our Business Administrator, Eric Pennington. Our Public Safety Director, Fritz G. Frage. Our Assistant Public Safety Director, Rufus L. Jackson. Our Deputy Director of Police Operations, Sharonda Morris. Our Deputy Director of Community Relations, Ronald Slaughter. Our Fire Chief, Del Ortiz. Our City of Newark's Council President and Central Ward Council Member, LaMonica R. McIver. And once again, our Council Member at Large, Reverend Louis Scott Roundtree. I'd also like to acknowledge the families of our fallen brothers. Captain Augusto Augiacabu and Captain Wayne Bear Brooks, who are in attendance today. Also in attendance are Irvington Fire Chief Antonio Gary, South Essex Fire Chief Joe Alvarez, and our UWASI partners, Director McCutsky, Stephen Dill, retired Chief of East Orange, retired Chief of Kearney, and also retired Chief of East Orange, Tim Weiss. I would also like to acknowledge the Newark Fire Division Command Staff. Chief of Training for the Newark Fire Division, Battalion Chief Stephen LaPenta. Captain Ramadan Edwards, as well as Captain Gerald Wyopen, and firefighter instructors Donald Alexander, Camilla Barnes, Gilberto Gonzalez, Jose Marrero, Andre Roberts. A special thanks is in order to the Morris County Public Safety Training Academy, the Morris County Public Safety Academy Director, Dan Colucci, retired Fire Marshal, Chief Louis Pepe, Fire Marshal, Deputy Chief Matthew Pasercio, and Lead Instructor, Rich Bizzari. Thank you all for attending today. If there was other uniformed personnel that I may have missed, thank you for your attendance. It is at this point that I would like to introduce the City of Newark's 40th mayor, a mayor who has continued to show commitment and support to our great city of Newark, a mayor who has relentlessly advocated for the upholding of public safety for our city and for the Newark Fire Division, the Honorable Mayor Roz J. Baraka.
Good afternoon. To Public Safety Director, Assistant Director, Chief Delotees, Fire Command staff, to no longer recruits, to our new firefighters that are here today. We welcome you and we thank you for enduring such a long and strenuous process on purpose. I'd like to thank the Clifton Fire Department, Denville Fire Department, and Dover Fire Department as well for joining us here today at this ceremony. So thank you all. They deserve a round of applause. Protocol already established. Want to again thank the business administrator, the council, the council that is that are here with us today, Councilwoman Roundtree, Council President MacGyver. Want to thank you for continually supporting the work of this administration, making sure that we put enough money in the budget to ensure that we are able to do what we're doing today. Welcome everybody to the William H. Mobile Ashby Community Care and Training Facility, newly built in the city of Newark. There are many trainings that happen here. I heard that somebody said that some folks aren't allowed to train here. That is absolutely not true. I want to reiterate that this is the police training academy and a fire training academy as well as community training at the same time. I don't think anything exists like this anywhere in the country, and it's a beautiful, beautiful building, by the way. So thank you all for coming here today. Welcome again to our academy and welcome to the city of Newark. I was at an event, I believe 2 days ago, and it was a young girl who got up from the city of Newark and she spoke very eloquently. I was at the Cityplex Theater on Springfield Avenue. Young lady said that her mother taught her to be a proud Puerto Rican, that she was Latina, and that she wanted to make history in the city of Newark, that she wanted to be the first Hispanic female to be the fire chief in the fire department here in the city of Newark. That warmed me because she could have said a number of things. She could have said she wanted to be an engineer, a doctor, a teacher, you know, all kinds of things that you think people want to hear from kids, because you want them to do these professions that we have in their mind. But she said that she always wanted to be in the fire department. I thought that was amazing. It also says to me that the work that these young men and women are doing every single day is not only life-saving work, it's life-inspiring work. And these young people in our city get an opportunity to see fine men and women risk their lives for other people, to walk in our community with dignity, with their shoulders back and their head up. And a uniform means something of prestige and value to them. It is our job to make sure we maintain that we walk in schools, in neighborhoods, in communities, that our community, our children in this city see the fire profession as not only a career, but a laudable and a laudable career with integrity that they can feel like that they want to advance towards in this city. I don't think she knew that we were having a graduating class today. It would be great if we could find this student, and some of you can go over there, the new recruits, and talk to her about your process of becoming a fire a person in the city of Newark, being a part of the fire division here. I think that that would be incredible. That's been on my mind since I heard it, and I knew we were going to be here today, so I wanted to say it to all of you. You guys are joining the fire department at a bittersweet time. Bitter because it's a time, as you marched in, you said and reminded us all of how dangerous this work is, that we actually lose lives and have lost lives along the way, that this is not easy work. This is difficult, scary, and dangerous work that everybody does not choose to do. The saying is people run out of fires and you guys run in. It is bitter. It's a bitter time. We're still mourning. We're still getting through difficulties. Bittersweet, sweet in a sense that we have bringing on the largest class that we've ever had in the history of this city, number one. Sweet because we are now getting ready to promote 8 safety officers, so that every incident so far going forward, we will have safety officers at every incident in the fire, every fire in the city that we ever have to go to. It is sweet because we're getting new apparatuses, because we're gonna open up a new firehouse downtown. It's sweet because we're gonna establish a team of fire officers that are top notch, right? A SWAT team, if you will, for the fire department. I'm excited about that, a task force. I'm super excited about that. And maybe some of you men and women can train even more to get prepared for that. I think this class has also got some ex-police officers in it as well. You know, some of you guys who were cops yesterday and firemen today got the best of both worlds. I know your colleagues may have something to say about that, but I think it's a great thing. I think that you've been trained twice and that you have a special opportunity that other people don't have. You've been able to see public safety from 2 different lenses. And I'm speaking to you directly because to whom much is given, much is required. And because you have twice the training, you should have to do twice the work. But we appreciate that. And I just want to say welcome to the Newark Fire Department, one of the busiest, the largest, the best fire departments in the state of New Jersey. I want to say I wish you the best, and I wish you well. And every day when you wake up, I pray that God renews your strength. And you mount wings like eagles, and you run and don't get tired, and you walk and don't faint. That every day when you go out of your home, that you take God with you. Because despite all the things that I promise, and everybody else promises, your battalion chiefs, your chiefs, all of those things are not guaranteed. The only thing that's guaranteed is the conversation you had with God. And when you're out there doing what you do and you think people aren't looking, God is always watching. And I pray that at the end of your tour, that you find a way to make what you said as you walked in this door a lie. That you get home to your family every single night, to your beautiful children, your wives, your mothers, your fathers, and you go to sleep and pray and you get up and you do it all over again the next day. As much as you can, as long as you can, as best as you can, with that uniform on that says Newark Fire Department. God bless you and Godspeed to you.
Thank you, Mayor Baraka. At this time, I would like to introduce the City of Newark's Department of Public Safety Director, Director Fritz G. Frage.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. First, I'd like to give praise and thanks to God. He woke me up as he woke everybody up this morning to be here today, to enjoy this beautiful day, and the privilege of being here, standing in front of you, to talk about the firefighters' graduation today. Thank you, Lord. I would like to thank the city for their proactivity in meeting the hiring needs of the Newark Fire Division, the entire public safety at hand. First, let me say thank you to Mayor Ross J. Baraka and Business Administrator Eric Pennington, the City Council, Council President MacGyver, Councilwoman Reverend Roundtree, and all the council members for all of their support these past year, 2 years to the Department of Public Safety. One thing I want to say is welcome to the William Mobile Ashby Community Care Training Center. We should all rise right now and give applause to the council, B.A. Pennington, and Mayor Ross J. Baraka. Stand up and rise and give them a round of applause for all the hard work. Not you, not you. You sit. We have to recognize you for all the hard work and support. Because this is why we have. When we have a facility of this magnitude, in fact, we have several buildings coming up, it takes a lot of work, effort, patience, timing to find the funding to pay for these things. We've got a lab that's coming up, we've got an evidence building that's coming up. That wouldn't be here without the leadership of our Mayor, Ross J. Baraka, and the support of the council members, council president, and the BA business administrator, Eric Payne, for pushing this through to make sure that we have what we need to do our jobs properly. This is a state-of-the-art training facility. It trains the police, fire, and all purposes of the community and community needs. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the two people that are charged with running this building, which is firefighter Latina Bird, who's standing in the corner, who helps manage and coordinate all of the training that happens here, which is a huge task in supporting, because she has to deal with cops and firefighters, which is a big concern. And then the community, to fit them into the picture to make sure that we can have training sessions here, security sessions here. So give her a round of applause. And lastly, I'd like to thank Captain Carrillo, who's the director of the Police Training Academy, who's also here working with her hand in hand. Where's Captain Carrillo at? They stand in the sidelines. They do a lot of work to get this job done. In Newark, when I came here in 2022, I've heard we do big things. Everything's big things in Newark. 78 new firefighters are coming into our ranks. 78. This is proof and positive that the city of Newark is fully committed to supporting this department. We strive to be number one. Currently, the city is opening a larger downtown district, new buildings going up, new entrepreneurs, make sure the community can buy housing, supporting the community to make sure that they're safe, providing places of refuge for the homeless. We're number one in a lot of things. Class number 51 made history today. They're the first class to have their graduating held in this beautiful facility. They're the largest class ever in the city of Newark. As a matter of fact, they're the largest class ever in the state of New Jersey. Everyone here, rise and give a round of applause for the class 51 of the Newark Fire Division. For our new firefighter, I am honored to welcome you here. I am not a firefighter by trade, but since coming here, I've learned a lot, and the heroism you show is second to none. The fire department is a family. It's a calling. Can you imagine that? You run into fires while everybody is running out. It takes a special person to do that. Your hard work and perseverance in the academy proves you deserve to be here. We are one cohesive group here in Newark. We are the community, and the community is us. You've got to embrace that and understand that the people in this city are you, are remnants of you, and you have to support them within that fashion and understand that. We are a family. It is important to recognize your families also. They join us here in support of you. I know you all supported all your loved ones while they're going to the academy, getting beat up, doing push-ups, pull-ups, running around, getting drenched, going through sweat and tears. That is nothing compared to the next 25 years of support you have to provide them. They're gonna come home stressed, tired, emotionally drained. They're gonna need you more than ever to support them, to push them, to drive them through. That continued support is gonna make them see the other side of why they're really here. The real purpose of them being here is to support and keep the citizens of this great city safe and keep each other safe. I'd be remiss if I didn't discuss Captain Brooks and Captain Akabu, who passed away last year. Their families are here. Michelle and Jason are here from the Brooks family, and the family of Akabu is here. Let's give them a round of applause. They paid the ultimate sacrifice. They supported this community. They're here. Let's give them a round of applause and show them the love they deserve. In closing, I'd like to say God bless, Godspeed, and whatever you need, we will be here for you to support you. Thank you.
Now I introduce to everyone the Newark Fire Division's Fire Chief, Chief Del Ortiz.
Good afternoon. Just so you know, the hat I bought is way too big, so I take it off, because if I've got to read, it falls into my speech and I won't get it right. So it's my pleasure to welcome all the family, friends, and distinguished guests in attendance today. And a special congratulations to the largest recruit class in our long 227-year history for the Newark Fire Department. And before I go forward and give the 51st recruit class what I hope will be good advice, I want to point out that graduating this many recruits in one class is no easy task. It took many people across multiple divisions working tirelessly to get them to this moment, and I'd like to thank them all. Mayor Baraka, Business Administrator Pennington, Newark City Council, Director Frage, Assistant Director Jackson, the entire executive staff of 480 Clinton Avenue, Morris County Training Academy, staff and instructor cadre, the entire staff of the Newark Fire Training Division, and all the instructors who worked hard over the last 3 months to get them field ready. This collaborative team put together the largest recruit class in the history of the Newark Fire Department, and we couldn't be prouder to stand with them in this landmark accomplishment. Class 51. You are now part of an elite group of people who are known as an interior aggressive firefighting team. And although being aggressive is important, it's what we do to save lives, it's equally important to be just as aggressive in obtaining knowledge as you will as stretching that first line in. You will be responding into a dynamic and evolving arena. The playing field will not be dictated by us. This will challenge you to stay ahead of the trends and hazards you may face every day. And only through continual training will you recognize these hazards as they surface, leading to confidence and proficiency in your new role as a professional firefighter. Starting Monday, you will put on your uniform, or what we like to call our costume, and you may be called upon to do some pretty heroic things throughout your long careers. And as rightfully you're hailed as heroes throughout the community, there are other heroes who sacrifice more. I call them the silent heroes. These are the moms, the dads, the husbands, the wives, brothers, sisters, families, and friends who let go of their own heroes and entrust us, the fire department, to carry them through a tour duty. It takes a lot for these silent heroes to sit back and watch you go out the door, hoping, wondering, some praying, that you will come back to them in the same condition you left the night before. And although they will beam with pride seeing you wear that patch, a patch that has become synonymous for bravery and compassion, I'd like you to keep something in mind. There may be times where these silent heroes may need rescuing too. And by letting them know that you are aware of the bravery that they display, by letting you go out the door to do this job, may bring much bigger rewards than any medal you may receive throughout your career for saving somebody's life. Going forward, every citizen within the city of Newark will rely on you and your team to make their day better. Keep in mind, nobody calls 911 on a good day. So when responding to these calls, it is your responsibility to maintain a positive stance on the tough calls as well as the routine ones. And taking the time to smile, talk, or even a quick hello as you walk in and out of your runs will endear you to the community in another way. It will show that behind the uniform is not only a brave individual, but a person who stands on the same side of humanity. And regardless of the career path we may all choose, you have chosen this profession because you want to make an impact throughout society. And it's not the uniform that's going to make that impact. It's you that will. Congratulations, Class 51.
Thank you, Chief Ortiz. Before I continue, I'd like to acknowledge East Ward Council Member Michael J. Silva. During the course of the Fire Academy, a competitive spirit is ignited amongst the recruits present here today, a spirit that will accompany them all throughout their journey as a Newark firefighter, a spirit that will encourage these individuals to always strive to outperform themselves from one incident to the next. All of these recruits before you here today possess this spirit. However, there are some that exemplify acts of academic and practical excellence, as well as exuberant leadership. We would like to take this time to recognize the following recruits for their outstanding achievements and performance: Director Frage, Director Jackson, and Chief Ortiz, please come forward. Mayor Baraka, may you please step forward as well. The Director's Academic Excellence Award presented by Director Fritz G. Frage goes to Patrick Kobelars. the Practical Excellence Award presented by Assistant Director Rufus L. Jackson goes to Alexander Boscaino. And the Fire Chief's Leadership Award, presented by Fire Chief Del Ortiz, goes to Kevin Barnes. As the Fire Academy draws to an end, it has become quite the tradition that each recruit class creates a memento, one that will forever score their names in Newark Fire's long line of history of recruit classes. At this time, the Newark Fire Division's 51st recruit class would like to present this memento to the City of Newark's Department of Public Safety, the Honorable Mayor Raj J. Baraka, Director Fritz G. Frage, Assistant Public Safety Director Rufus L. Jackson, and Fire Chief Del Ortiz. May you please step forward once again.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am recruit Brianna Martins, and I have the greatest honor and privilege to be presenting the plaque for Class 51. Over the last 13 weeks, Class 51 has learned that being a firefighter not only takes physical skill, but essential characteristics. Courage is at the heart of what firefighters do. It's the strength they summon to face dangerous situations, the determination to act despite fear, and the resiliency to persevere in the most challenging circumstances. Every day, firefighters display courage as they rush into burning buildings, rescue people from perilous situations, and confront emergencies head on. Making split-second decisions to protect lives and property. This bravery, which inspires us all, was displayed by Augustu Augie Akabu and Wayne Bear Brooks, with both perished in the line of duty while fighting a fire on July 5th, 2023. Selfless service is the cornerstone of firefighting. Both Augie and Brooks dedicated themselves to the well-being of others, often risking their own safety to help those in need. They prioritized the greater good over personal gain, working tirelessly to protect lives, property, and communities from harm. Their commitment to serving others, even in the face of great danger, embodies the highest ideals of public service and altruism. Valor is just one of the defining qualities of these firefighters. Their courage, bravery, and willingness to confront danger to protect others and serve their communities demonstrates valor. Every time they entered a burning building or responded to an emergency, putting their own safety at risk just to save lives. Their commitment to duty and selflessness in the face of danger is truly admirable. They tirelessly put themselves in harm's way to protect others and deserve recognition for their bravery and selflessness. Honoring their memory is a noble gesture. Honoring their bravery and sacrifice of two firefighters whose actions were selflessness and dedication to keep our community safe and at a great personal expense. I'd like to thank you all for being here, and I'd like to thank those who unfortunately cannot make it. Because of you guys, we are the reason we can stand as tall as we are. Thank you so much.
Would recruits Justin Akabu and recruit Tyler Pino please stand? I would like to take the opportunity to acknowledge that recruits Justin Akabu and Tyler Pino are direct relatives of our fallen brother, Captain Augusto Augie Akabu. They will continue to honor him by carrying his legacy in the Newark Fire Division. May the Brooks family and the Akabu family please stand up. Each one of these recruits here before you today will carry the legacy of our fallen brothers, Captain Augusto Augie Akabu and Captain Wayne Bear Brooks. I'd like to take this time to also acknowledge Battalion Chief Gay, Battalion Chief Barrichiano, retired Fire Captain DeFrancesco, and former Oakland Fire Chief Leroy. Can you please stand? Their sons are in this class. And they too have the duty of carrying their father's legacies in the Newark Fire Division. And now, the moment we have all been waiting for, the oath of office. I now ask that the Honorable Mayor Raj J. Baraka please step forward once again to administer the oath of office for the largest Newark Fire Division's 51st recruit class. May Director Frage and Fire Chief Ortiz please step forward as well.
Good afternoon. My name is Mayor Raj J. Baraka, Mayor of City of Newark. I'm here this afternoon to administer the oath of office for our firefighters. Please repeat after me. I state your name.
I,
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance, to the same, and to the governments established in the United States, and in this state, under the authority of the people. I do solemnly swear, that I will faithfully, impartially, and justly perform all the duties of the Office of Firefighter, Fire Division, Department of Public Safety, City of Newark, according to the best of my ability. So help me God. Congratulations, folks. It gives me the highest honor and a great pleasure to now introduce to you the 51st recruit class, the largest recruit class in the 227-year history of the Newark Fire Division. They're going to go right now. The certificates. The mayor. As we proceed with our program, the presentation of the graduation certificates indicates the completion of academy training. As I call your name, please step forward. I ask that everyone please hold your applause until all the names have been read. Thank you. Firefighter Janae Plaza. Firefighter Brianna Martins. Yes.
firefighter Joshua Huber. Firefighter Jimmy McKinsella. Firefighter Nicholas Rodriguez. Firefighter Francesco Bellamo. Firefighter Juan Cosme. Firefighter Francesco Barrichiano. Firefighter Christopher Kelly. Firefighter Gabriel Costa.
A legend in the fire department, Macho Miller's nephew. Because that's what he went by, Macho.
Firefighter John Conway. Firefighter Jailene Okendo. Firefighter Dominic Magliaro. Firefighter Alex Gillespie. Firefighter Nicholas Vellante. Firefighter Hector Ortiz. Firefighter Carlos Laracuente. Firefighter Christopher Nunez Castillo. Firefighter Danny Andrade. Firefighter Joseph DeFrancesco. Firefighter Justin Dunn. Firefighter Christian Trapani. Firefighter Dwanil Kadakia. Firefighter Gerard Angelo. Firefighter Agustin Oliveira. Firefighter Andrew Chardoff. Firefighter Jonathan Cardoso. Firefighter Joseph Amari. Firefighter Jonathan Deacon Rogers. Firefighter Jonathan Deacon Rogers. Firefighter Angel Masonave. Firefighter Christopher Conard. Firefighter Lorenzo Orsi. Firefighter Samuel Englishman. Firefighter Levi Soto. Firefighter Andrew Rivas. Firefighter Timothy Murray Jerry, Jr. Firefighter Nicholas Miller, who is son to Chief Brian Miller from North Hudson Regional, who is present here today, and grandson to Newark Fire Division legend, Macho Miller. Firefighter Shane McGowan. Firefighter Anthony Santiago. Firefighter Kai Reynolds. We're halfway, folks. Firefighter Gabriel Majorano. Firefighter Joshua Paul. Firefighter Joshua Betts. Firefighter Enrique Arroyo. Firefighter Anthony Ramos. Firefighter Albin Furman. Firefighter Luis Cancel. Firefighter Justin Acabo. Firefighter Gabriel Dos Santos. Firefighter Cole Hadley. Firefighter Kevin Gowiler. Firefighter James Giuncini Jr. Firefighter Stephen Downer. Firefighter Gina Arroyo. Firefighter Kevin Champo. Firefighter Tyler Bingu. Firefighter Ryan Ferreira. Firefighter Jason Brofsky. Firefighter Christopher O'Connor. Firefighter Daniel Whip. Firefighter Angel Valentin. Firefighter Jason Torres. Firefighter Alexander Buscano. Firefighter Patrick Kobolars. Firefighter Carlos Cruz Garcia. Firefighter Jabril Paul. Firefighter Brian Morris. Firefighter Michael McHugh. Firefighter Sean Evera. Firefighter Kevin Bates. Firefighter Rohit Nalamala. Firefighter Kevin Barnes. Firefighter Damian Gonzalez. Firefighter Kevin Gay. Firefighter Ethan Leroy. Firefighter Joshua Terpstra. Firefighter Michael Valerius. Firefighter Kyle Caulfield. I'd like to take a second to acknowledge Councilmember at Large C. Lawrence Crump. At this time, Recruit Class 51 will recite the Firefighter Creed. Please take as many photos as possible at the current moment. I'd like to take a moment to also acknowledge Bishop Designate Vincent M. Rouse Sr. from Pleasant Grove Baptist Church Southward Interfaith Clergy Alliance. Everyone okay with the pictures? At this time, I ask that everyone please stand for Deputy Director Ronald Slaughter, who will lead us in our closing prayer.
Every head bowed, every eye closed. To the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the God that covered those men as they entered the fiery furnace, we pray that that God will cover these men and women who have devoted their lives to serve. God, it is our prayer that as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the fire, they did not smell like fire. They didn't even look like they had been in the fire. We pray that same covering over these men and these women. God, your word reminds us, those that desire to be great among us must be a servant. And as they have committed their lives to be servants, we pray your blessings upon each and every one of them. But we also pray your blessings upon their family, who will worry at night sometimes. But God, you didn't give us the spirit of fear, but you gave us love and a sound mind. And we pray that same love and sanity over these firefighters. In your name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Deputy Director Ronald Slaughter. On behalf of the Department of Public Safety and the Newark Fire Division, I would like to thank everyone for their attendance today, for this very memorable moment of history making for our largest recruit class, the 51st recruit class, and again, to congratulate our newest firefighters. In closing, I ask that everyone please sit for the blessing of the Newark Fire Division's newest additions to our fleet, a new Rescue One truck and our new tower ladder by Bishop Designate Vincent M. Rouse Sr. from Pleasant Grove Baptist Church Southward Interfaith Clergy Alliance.
To our mayor and director, and to you, our new firefighters for the city of Newark, can we give them one more good round of applause, everybody? To our council and to all who have gathered, we will now ask the Lord's blessings over the vehicles that they will use to be change agents here in the city of Newark. We will start this prayer with this scripture: I will lift up mine eyes to the hills, from where my help comes from. My help comes from the Lord. He makes heaven and earth. He will not let my foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, who watches over Israel will not slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming out and your going in, both now and forevermore. And so, Father, we ask, oh God, that you would bless these vehicles, anoint these trucks, bless these apparatus, oh God, as they use them to save lives here in the city of Newark. We pray, oh God, that your protection, love would be on them, would be around them. We pray, oh God, for the equipment on them. We pray, oh God, for the families that will be blessed because of them. And we pray, oh God, for these Newark firefighters who will ride them, who will drive them, and use them, oh God, to save your people. And we thank you
for the blessings, O God, of this now. We pray that you would anoint it, that your Holy Spirit would hover over it. And we pray, Lord God, that you would continue to keep these whom you have anointed in this time and this season. And we thank you for the victory because it's already ours because you blessed these 78 recruits now to be firefighters here in the city of Newark. And we thank you for these vehicles they will use. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
This concludes our ceremony. Thank you, everyone, for attending.